This is the newest laser engraver from LaserPecker, the LaserPecker 4. It is the world's first laser engraver that comes with a dual laser system, which enables you to engrave almost any material seamlessly. Is it any good? Should you just buy this once and for all? And is it the legit successor of its blockbuster, the LaserPecker 2? Hey, what's up? Sam here. I've been with the LaserPecker 4 prototype for more than a week, and here's my review. This is probably the most detailed review you can find about this machine so far. I've worked through many nights just to make this video for you guys. So please subscribe if you haven't. Of course, if you guys just want to check out its engraving ability, you can just jump right to here. Without further ado, let's get started. Compared to its predecessor or many other laser engravers I've tested, I found there are several new accessories that's unique and original. The first is what they have called the Rotary Extension. This one lets you engrave on objects like ball, cones, or cups with a non-cylindrical shape. These kinds of shapes are just impossible for other laser engravers because the surface is not flat, so they cannot focus properly on the surface. This accessory lets you mount those objects in a flat way. That's smart. It has angle marks on the right-hand side, so you can adjust to the angle as precisely as you want, and then rotate the dial to fix the angle. There's a lock button on the top. Once you align the arrow to the hole on the spin axis, then you can press down to lock the head. There is a clamp part. You can rotate the dial to match different diameters, or you can add different clamps for different objects, like something extra large, like this cup, or super tiny, like a ring. Just in case you want to know other features of this genius rotary extension, it has two USB-A ports and one Type-C port on the back. In order to engrave smoothly, for example, large cylindrical objects, sometimes we need to put another support as well. As we can see, there are two wheels there. This part is for supporting ball-shaped objects, which I will show you later. There's a lock on the bottom, and we have a dial here, which you can rotate to adjust the height. We insert the support from the other end of this rotary extension. We clamp one end, and then put the other end to this support. We adjust the height to let the object lay flat. After everything is fixed, we lock it. That's it. The second new accessory is this slide extension. With it, you can engrave a size up to 300mm by 160mm. It has two USB-A ports and one Type-C port on the side. Unlike the LaserPecker 2, where the leaf nip bracket is fixed to the base, the one on the 4 is separated. We have two arrows on the top to let you lift or lower the engraver. As we can see, this part is tightly sealed, which prevents dust from going inside. This also makes the whole thing look beautiful, right? There is a Type-C there to let you connect to the power source so you can slide it. One interesting thing that I found is you can even use this leaf nip pole as a slider for your phone or camera. Well, another way to use it. By the way, it's very quiet, super quiet. That's basically all the new accessories. Now, moving to the most important thing, the LaserPecker 4. If we compare it with the previous generations, the first change for the 4 is it has added a rounded color display. We'll talk about that in a second. The most significant change for the 4th generation, of course, is it's now embedded with a dual net source laser system. One is 1064nm and the other is 450nm. For what these two lasers are specifically for, I will put the engraving ability testing part. I think this is what makes different from other laser engravers on the market today. If you are interested, the rest of the designs of the LaserPecker 4 are on the main unit. These are all the ports. And here at the bottom, we have two red light source ports here, which allows you to adjust the focus. For others, it has very much the same design as the second and the third generation. Now, let's put the thing to use. To use the laser engraver, it's very easy. We first install the lifting pole to the base, then the bracket to the lifting pole. After that, we attach the shield to the main unit. Just make sure these two holes align with the red light ports on the main unit. The shield is magnetic, by the way. Then we'll fix the laser engraver main unit to the bracket. Screw it tightly. Easy peasy. After that, we connect the main unit to the lifting pole and connect the main unit to the power source. And that's it. The screen will light up. Now a little bit more about the display. You swipe left or right to switch between different lasers. The 1064 nanometer and 450 nanometer. Here the moon icon is the sleep mode. Gently touch to enter and then touch to awake the screen. Here on the right is the printing history, where you can see all the engravings you printed. Click once and we see some parameters there. You can choose to preview or print directly. With such a display, you can print things in bulk without even connecting to your phone. Speaking of phone, let me walk you through the app very quickly. This app from LaserPecker is one of the best, and this time it's even better made. It's like going from amateur to expert level. The biggest change is basically to adjust the light bring interface to the size of your phone. You can import pictures from your phone and apply different modes to it, like pencil, G-code, BMW tracer, and then adjust different parameters to it. Do your own drawings. Basically, everything you can think of, it has. The best part is now it supports layer engraving. What that means is that you can set parameters for different layers. Like in the video, there are three different elements: fill, picture, and line. You can apply different parameters to each respectively. What are they for? Now, with the LaserPecker 4, you can let the machine automatically cut a picture after engraving. This is something I have never seen on any other laser engravers. Before, you had to wait for it to finish engraving, then draw an outline and cut. Lots of hassle. Speaking of the engraving ability, let me put more about this, because I think this is definitely what separates the men from the boys for such portable laser engravers. The LaserPecker 4 is the first consumer level laser engraver that features two light source lasers inside. It has a 10 watts 450 nanometer laser and 2 watts 1064 nanometer laser. We know that many diet laser engravers can only cover a certain amount of materials, like for the 450 nanometer laser engraver that can only cover things like wood, leather, or painted metals. They cannot have good results on plastics and metals like stainless steel, copper, gold, etc. So you have to use a 1064 nanometer laser to engrave these non-painted metal materials or plastics. However, for the 1064 nanometer laser, it cannot do well on normal materials like wood, bamboo, or paper. So you see, these two lasers are kind of complementary, right? So in order to make one laser engraver work for all materials, so many manufacturers come up with a switchable laser head so it can engrave on almost all materials like the Mr. Carver M3 that I tested before. But here for the LaserPecker 4, it saves all those switching steps. It lets you switch these two lasers in just a swipe. So if you want to engrave things like coasters, wood, or painted metal, those materials just use 450 nanometer laser. Or for stainless metal or plastics, you use 1064 nanometer laser. So basically, you can see this is one machine made for all materials. Here are the results. They are good, right? Just check out the details on different materials I've tested. I mean, with the LaserPecker's previous years of successful laser products, the results weren't to be bad, even with this LaserPecker 4 in its early stages. Here is the most amazing part. Since they have dual lasers, it can engrave something with two materials seamlessly. Let's say you want to create some decorations for Christmas, like engraving stainless steel cubes and wood cubes at the same time. You can now engrave them in just one pass, without switching laser heads. And for this keyboard, we have several keys made of wood and the rest are plastic. You can even do this in just one pass as well. This is crazy. Just ask an expert. This is mind-blowing. It's just not possible for previous laser engravers. The reason LaserPecker can achieve this is, as they told me, because the light source control system and the app are all self-developed by themselves. So they can adjust its software and the hardware to the perfect level. What's also impressed me is the fast engraving ability. just check this out. It's easy to understand why it's so fast, because it comes with a high-speed galvanometer together with a higher power laser than the LaserPecker 2 or 3. And of course, it will be much faster than those Core XY laser engravers. I also tested the cutting ability. I tested it can cut 5mm thickness wood in one pass. I actually tested a 30mm thick piece of wood. It cuts as well after multiple times. And this time, since it offers those innovative accessories, so you can engrave something unusual, like this cone-shaped cup or Christmas decorations. It allows you to engrave something extra small, like rings, both outside and in. Just check it out. This slide extension lets you print something extra large and long, and you can also print in bulk with it repeatedly multiple times. Lastly, is the safety. Once it detects the shield is off, it will stop engraving, or when it detects movement, it will also stop engraving. Perfect for families with kids or pets. So here it is. My conclusion for the LaserPecker 4 is one sentence. If you just want one laser engraver for all the possible materials you want to work on, and for those who want to spend more time enjoying engraving and less time working on it, this is it. Just go and get it. This one gives you the best results, while at the same time saving you tons of time, so you can just focus on the projects you want to do. And by far, this is the best consumer laser engraver I've ever tested, and I truly recommend it. With the LaserPecker's successful and the practicalities of its laser engraving products, you can buy with the least worry. Normally, when I'm reviewing a crowdfunding product, I always ask backers to check out the background of the company, because it might be a scam, or the final product might be a totally different one. But not for LaserPecker. I've tested their products since the first generation, and the final product is always beyond expectation and much more refined than the prototype. Let me share with you a story. When I tested the prototype of the LaserPecker 2, that slide extension was a plastic one. But when I received the official version, it became this well-polished metal roller. From my experience, this could definitely increase costs, so I contacted LaserPecker to see why they changed this, and they replied because they received one feedback. One user burned the rubber part, so they had to change in order for safety, no matter what the cost. See, in my years of dealing with tech companies, seldom companies can do that. The LaserPecker 2 was released in 2020, and for the whole of 2021, they didn't release any new products, because the whole company devoted its time to make sure they could deliver tens of thousands of orders for the LaserPecker 2 successfully. And they succeeded on that. And I'm pretty sure with that spirit, the LaserPecker 4 is going to be an unprecedented successful product for the laser engraving industry. Thanks for watching, my Sammy. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Merry Christmas.
That's what Christmas is all about.